On September 30th, 2015, Russia began airstrikes against ISIS and its affiliates in Syria. These strikes were conducted at the request of the Syrian government. Iran followed, announcing that they were preparing to send in ground troops. These developments completely changed the geopolitical equation, not just in Syria. Western politicians and their corporate media lapdogs are obviously not happy about where this is headed, and they've taken to the airwaves in force to voice their condemnation. First, they claimed that Russia was hitting moderate U.S.-backed rebels rather than exclusively focusing on ISIS.
Of course, he moved all the capabilities in. He built the runways. He built the establishment and then was ready to strike. And instead of revealing anything to Kerry from Lavrov or from him to Obama, he has a Russian general show up at our embassy in Baghdad an hour before it starts. And what's the first target? The people we are supporting and arming and training and equipment. What better way to stick their thumb in our eye?
Hey, wait a second. On September 16th, General Lloyd Austin of the U.S. Central Command testified that there were only 4 or 5 U.S.-trained fighters in all of Syria. And now these fighters are supposedly in control of an entire region? This assertion would be absurd enough on its own, but the reality of the matter is that the area in question has been controlled by al-Nusra for at least 2 years. And just so we're clear here, al-Nusra is al-Qaeda's Syrian branch, and they have direct alliances with ISIS. Not that the distinction between al-Nusra and the FSA would really change the equation. The FSA has publicly acknowledged on several occasions that they are cooperating with al-Nusra, and the FSA command itself has been dominated by Islamic extremists since at least 2012.
أما فيما يخص بعض الفصائل التي مثلا يطالب الغرب بتصنيفها كمنظمة إرهابية جبهة النصرة نعم نحن نشعر أن هذه الجبهة بمكان ما هي يمكن الحوار معها
حول
نعم حول طبيعة الدولة القادمة حول شكل الدولة القادمة حول إمكانية هذه البلد على إقامة دولة التي تناسب الجميع نحن في مكان ما يجب أن نتعاون ويجب أن نتحاور وأنا على صلة بالجميع أنا على صلة بالجميع ولا أخفي سرا بذلك حتى فيما يخص يعني الأخوة في جبهة النصرة ونتعاون في أماكن كثيرة.
So if the FSA and al-Nusra work together and al-Nusra is working with ISIS, why haven't those funding and arming the FSA been charged with providing material support to terrorists? Russia's airstrikes are killing civilians. Look, we have proof from the White Helmets, an NGO funded by the UK government. That's funny. This image looks an awful lot like this one, which was posted on September 25th, 5 days before the airstrikes even began. That was a bit problematic, so they deleted the tweet, but not before the US and its allies would use the occasion to take their hypocrisy to a new level. On October 2nd, the U.S. issued a joint statement with France, Germany, the U.K., Turkey, Saudi Arabia, and Qatar, calling for Russia to, quote, immediately cease its attacks on the Syrian opposition and civilians. Just to put this into perspective, the Saudis have been bombing Yemen, with U.S. support, since March of 2015, killing thousands of civilians and creating a humanitarian crisis of epic proportions. The irony also seemed to be lost on Washington, who after decades of military occupations and drone campaigns, which have killed millions of civilians, topped it off by repeatedly bombing a Doctors Without Borders hospital in Afghanistan just 1 day later. Oh, this is awkward. What can we do to save face? Hey, our friend John McCain has an idea. We should just send our moderate jihadists some more weapons.
They're attacking the very guys who we want to see topple Assad. You would let American planes just continue to pass them and let them do that?
No, but I might do what we did in Afghanistan many years ago to give those guys the ability to shoot down those planes. That equipment is available.
Who would be shooting them down?
The Free Syrian Army. Just like the Afghans shot down the Russian. No, just like the Afghans shot down Russian planes after Russia invaded Afghanistan.
So we armed extremists in Afghanistan, which became the Taliban, which we're still bombing, often inaccurately, to this day. And you want to do it again? This isn't a plan. This is desperation. Washington has been outmaneuvered. This turn of events is on par with a 2013 episode where the US-backed rebels got caught using sarin gas against civilians. Only now, there aren't nearly as many options left. With Russia providing air support and Iran assisting in the ground campaign, the US no longer has any leverage in Syria. And if Putin is able to maintain momentum, this could very well be a turning point regionally as well. That doesn't mean the game is over, though. The The U.S. and its allies aren't going to just walk away from this. You can rest assured that Washington is scrambling to cook something up right now. And if the last few years are any indicator, this could get very interesting. This video is Creative Commons. You have permission to download and distribute any and all of our content through any venue, commercial or non-commercial. If you want more people to see this information, please remember to like, share, and comment. If you want to see how far the rabbit hole really goes, keep in touch. Subscribe to Stormcloudsgathering on YouTube, follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+, and you can sign up for email notifications of new releases on our website, stormcloudsgathering.com. We also want to say thank you to all of you who donated this past month to keep this project going, and to all of you who have offered to volunteer. There aren't enough hours in the day to respond to each of you individually, but you have made a difference.